Good day, everyone. This is Mark Johnson, your fitness ambassador from Bounce Pep and the youngest son of Bill Johnson. Please do me a favor now and just hit the like button. And also, if you would be so kind, push the bell icon so that you receive notifications when we release a new video. And I just want to talk to you today a little bit about the food that you are putting in your body and specifically about time and cost. I know that you may be busy, you may feel that you don't have a lot of time, or you may feel that maybe you just have other priorities, and so you don't necessarily want to spend a lot of time preparing a meal. And what you do is you go out and you just find the fastest thing will end up being the cheapest thing. So you find the fastest and cheapest thing that you can get your hands on, and it's not necessarily great for your health. And you pretty much know that, but you do it because you kind of feel cornered in by your schedule. Like you really don't feel like you have time to be making, a nutritious meal and really staying on top of your diet properly. So I understand that you may feel that pressure, but I want you to rethink that a bit and maybe prioritize your diet a little bit more. Now, let me just qualify this by saying I am not some kind of a professional dietitian. So I'm just talking common sense here. If you've got common sense, you should be able to hear this and understand exactly what I mean. Okay, so just think of it as you and me talking together right now, having this dialogue based on common sense. So a lot of times you might just run out and get a burger, some fries or whatever from the nearest fast food joint, maybe some cheap tacos or something like that. I think you know what I'm talking about. And again, it could just be because of convenience, but you have to understand that long term, it's not really a good habit for you to indulge in. So your arteries are real things, and they are inside of your body, and they really do clog up. You can have a buildup of plaque inside of your arteries when you're eating a lot of this fast food that over time will give you heart problems. If you have a habit of eating a lot of fast food, a lot of, fried foods, then over time, that will affect your heart, it will affect your respiratory system. So you have to be careful about indulging in that. And that means that you may have to inconvenience yourself some by taking more time to prepare meals properly. Or if you can't prepare the meals yourself, then just eat something a little bit healthier than, fast food or something all the time. Be aware of what you're eating. If you're eating fried food several times a week, I think you know that that's not a good thing, but you may be doing it out of convenience. But again, I think you know that that's not really a great thing to do for your health. So you want to rethink this and maybe reprioritize a little bit. Sometimes, even though you feel like you don't have time to make a proper meal or get a proper meal from a different place, the fact of the matter is, if you think that way and you continue to have poor dietary habits where you're taking in a lot of saturated fats, a lot of processed, like refined sugars and things like that, and it's just habitual, so you're doing this all the time, well, guess what? You're gonna have a whole lot of time to be visiting the pharmacy and sitting up in the hospital. So I want you to understand this. The time that you're trading off, you think you're saving time by getting this fast food, but believe me, on the back end, you're gonna give all that time back sitting up in the hospital on the operating table in pharmacies. So Think long term when it comes to how you eat. I am not I'm not self-righteous or anything when it comes to eating. And I understand that everybody has cravings. Everybody wants to indulge sometimes. So I actually support that. You can eat anything that you want. What I'm talking about is when you are eating all the time, fast, cheap food, that's not good for you. Okay, that's what I'm talking about. People who are doing this all the time, I want you to hear me. You think you're saving time, but you are going to give all that time back on the back end when you start getting sickly and coming down with all kinds of bad conditions. You don't feel good. You don't have the energy you should have. And you end up on medications. I've made another video about this before, talking about, you know, why you don't want to be in the hospital on medications. I believe it was called the hospitals for the birds. That's what it was called. So this is kind of a follow-up on that. And just take it to heart, please. Watch what you eat. Watch what you drink. You don't need to have a sugary drink every time you have a meal. I mean, do you understand? You can have a meal and just have some water, maybe carbonated water or some tea. Like, it doesn't have to have sugar in it. You can have a full meal with something that's not sweet. That stuff is going to come back to haunt you if you're doing it all the time, okay? So again, take this with you. I just wanted to share again some common sense advice with you. This is not some kind of professional advice from a dietitian, but I guarantee you they would basically tell you the same thing. They would tell you exactly the same thing I'm saying, which is, you know, you really can't afford to be eating fast food and fried food and, you know, drinking sweetened drinks all the time because you feel like you don't have time to either prepare a proper meal or go to a different, establishment, a different restaurant or something that can prepare a proper meal for you. Okay. So go ahead, take that with you today. And please, please follow up, because Bounce Pep wants you to live and live well. And you can't do that if you are sick and in the hospital. Take care, everybody. All right. Talk to you next time.